Good night, everyone.
Okay, now, so it's the time. That inevitable moment. Well, it was unavoidable. This is when we shine the spotlight on those that bring us down, down, down.
Heaven help us.
Uh-huh. Here are the bass instruments, and I'm going to introduce them, please. We're going to start with the bassoons. There are four bassoons. Here we are. One, contra, sarrusophone. In the clarinet section, we have four bass clarinets. We have two contrabass clarinets of different sizes. Good. In the saxophones, let's go over to the baritone saxophones. There are four of them up there. In the brass, there are six baritones and euphoniums. Shameless. Okay. Six tubas up there. That always looks so impressive. One bass guitar. Yes. We have one string bass as well. Yes. Over here in the timpani, we have four timpani. There he is. And we have a bass drum. There it is. Okay. Take it away, John. What are we going to do with these instruments? Can you take the next part?
I just thought I'd let you know there was some evil in the air. I saw it earlier, but I don't see it now. So be warned. It may have been debris from the Death Star, but it was flying there. Oh well. Bombardon is the name given to the first ever valved bass or contrabass brass instrument. That's a mouthful. In military bands, also called a bass tuba. Nowadays, the originally French name Bombardon indicates any instrument that resonates in the very low bass range. Acting as allied forces, the low-pitched instruments are pleased to present their featured song called the Bombastic Bombardon. Thank you. Their own horns, don't they? Moving on.